It's time for the weekly No Pain, No Gain market update with a team at Payne Capital Management here in New York City.
Good morning. This is Bob Payne, Chief Investment Officer of Payne Capital Management. And the market continued its winning ways this week with many markets across the globe hitting new highs. And the S&P 500 is poised to make stock market history, even if it does nothing next week. The S&P is 1 week away from setting the longest winning streak without a 3% correction in history. The broad market hasn't experienced a decline of 3% or more since November of 2016. That's the best run in 20 years. So with the longest winning streak in market history, every major stock index that matters at historic highs, low volatility, and synchronized global economic growth, you would think the average investor would be wildly bullish. Not so, says Rich Bernstein, the former investment strategist at Merrill Lynch. Rich penned this week that actual equity allocation among individual investors, pensions, endowments, foundations, and hedge funds remains more focused on limiting their downside risk of their stock portfolio than on potential opportunities. See, investors tend to be wildly bullish when a bull market is in the bottom of the ninth inning with two outs and two strikes on the batter. We can find no investor class that's showing such over-enthusiasm for stocks. He goes on to write, there are three indicators he watches to determine if a bear market could be on the horizon. Those three things are corporate profits, liquidity, and sentiment valuation. Now, corporate profits are accelerating. Liquidity within the United States remains abundant. And stock valuations, well, they're still relatively low when you compare them to the yield available on cash and bonds. He continues to believe there's plenty of opportunity in the global equity market, and investors should ignore the media noise about short-term volatility and an imminent market collapse, and stick to the business of asset allocation.